Hi, I'm Robin Zimmerman. Welcome to North of the Broad. We are in our new home in downtown Buford, the Pat Conroy Literary Center. We've got a great show planned for you, so stay tuned. It's so nice to welcome the Executive Director of the Pat Conroy Literary Center, Jonathan Haupt. Welcome, Jonathan.
Thank you.
So glad to have you on our show and to be in this beautiful, amazing museum and interpretive center. It's stunning. So tell us a little bit about what all is here.
Well, this center is really a museum to Pat's life as both a writer and a teacher, and we have some wonderful artifacts. We're actually sitting in front of Pat Conroy's writing desk, where many of his books were written longhand on yellow legal pads, and we're surrounded by many of his books as well. But beyond that, we also have material from movies that were made based on Pat's books, so we're actually seated next to the Prince of Tides exhibit case as well here, too. So there's a lot of things for people to sort of lose themselves in when they visit us.
And you had a very special relationship with Pat Conroy. Tell us a little bit about the history of your relationship and how you became the executive director and got involved in all of this.
Sure. Well, Pat was a great mentor and friend to me. He and I created a fiction imprint together called Story River Books when I was director of the University of South Carolina Press in Columbia. And together, during the last 5 years of his life, Pat and I selected and published 22 books, short story collections and novels together, and it was a transformative experience for me. So when he passed away and this living legacy was created to him, this Conroy Center, it was my absolute honor to come here and be the first executive director for the center.
Perfect fit. And so besides the center, the museum, all the artifacts and so forth, you do a lot of educational events here.
That's right.
And you have a monthly book club. So talk a little bit about that.
We do. Well, Pat published 12 books during his lifetime, and we thought if we took a year and 1 month out of the year we addressed each one of those books, we could get through all of them. And we do those meetings right here in the Conroy Center. So we're a couple of months in now. And folks have signed up, but the July book club still has registration available for it. And we're actually looking at Lords of Discipline that month too, on July 16th.
Okay.
We've got Sean Houston, who's a professor of English at the Citadel, who teaches the Lords of Discipline at the Citadel, who's coming to lead our discussion for that group.
And how long does that last? And kind of what happens during the book club
meeting? It's about an hour that we do right here in the center, again, surrounded by the artifacts. And we are recording those. We are broadcasting them on YouTube for folks who can't attend in person. But it's an interactive discussion. So we're relying on folks to read the book or at least be familiar with it when they come and have questions and thoughts in mind. And our discussion leader is always somebody who's deeply connected to the work, who can really get to the heart of what that experience was about.
Very cool. I'm very excited about this Camp Conroy.
Yes.
So it's your second annual Camp Conroy. It's going to be the last 2 weeks in June for writers and illustrators, young people, ages?
Ages 8 to 15. We're going to split them into two groups by age this time. And we're out at Buford Middle School, which is a wonderful partner for so many things that we do.
Good.
Buford Middle School was Buford High School when Pat Conroy was a student there, and later when he came back as a teacher. So it's great to work at that school. But over the course of the 2 weeks in Camp Conroy, these kids are going to write, illustrate, edit, design, and publish a 32-page book together. It's a remarkable experience to have.
Wow, and they can have that to then share and,
exactly.
and use and grow and learn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And of course, November is the Literary Festival.
That's right.
And so the dates, I think, are the first through the third.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
But the schedule is not published yet.
No, not until July, but we're going to start announcing some of our headliners and some of our key events very soon, too, because people have come from 24 states to come to that festival. It means a lot to so many people who are invested in Pat Conroy or Southern literature or Buford or the Lowcountry, and we're just thrilled to be able to welcome them every year.
And it's the fourth annual, and for those 3 days, what all, of course, obviously there's book signings and educational events, but what else occurs?
There's performances, there's workshops, we do a lot of social gatherings as well, and there are tours, both of Beaufort, and we've gone out to Dufusky Island and done tours out there as well. And the events take place here in Beaufort, also in Bluffton, and out on Dauta Island. So we're really spread out across the county too. It's a chance for people to see a lot of Buford, all in the through the lens of literature.
Wow, what a treasure this center is, and thank you for your leadership. And we're so excited to have this be our new home for North of the Broad. Thank you, Jonathan, so much.
Thank you. My pleasure.
We'll be seeing you next month.
Absolutely.
And we'll be right back.